يقول الله تعالى في القرآن المجيد مخبرا وآمرا قولا كريما إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا ومولانا محمد وأصحابه وبارك وسلم. My respected elders, mothers and fathers, brothers and sisters, and all our beautiful children, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah, all thanks, praise, and glory belong only to Almighty Allah Azza wa Jal, who is the only true sovereign of the skies and the earth. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له. I bear witness that there is none worthy of worship but Allah alone, and Allah Almighty has no partner whatsoever. وأشهد أن سيدنا ونبينا ومولانا محمدا عبده ورسوله. And I bear witness that I believe in all the prophets. And I bear witness that Sayyidina Muhammad ibn Abdullah, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, is the absolute final of all divine emissaries and prophets from Allah. We thank Almighty Allah for having gathered us here on this beautiful, auspicious day of Jum'ah in this most beautiful masjid, Masjid al-Quds, where Allah has brought us together to recharge our spiritual batteries, that we can reconnect to the divine in order to take us through this week when we come next Friday to recharge our batteries again, inshallah. And I want us to focus on that incident when Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam one day was speaking to his noble and beloved Sahaba. And he said to them, "Oh, my beloved Sahaba, let me explain to you one of the scenes that will take place on the inevitable day of judgment. On that great day of judgment, when everyone will be assembled, the entire humanity and the entire jinn kind and all creation of Allah will be resurrected. And we will be standing on the Maidani Hashr, the plane of accountability." Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, "Out of the whole of mankind, there will be a category of people who will be seated ala manabirim min nur. They will be seated on mimbars and thrones of nur. And they will be the envy of everyone. Even prophets will envy them and ask, who are these people that they have such a lofty position, an exalted position in the eyes of Allah on this mighty day of judgment?" And listen how the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam replied to them. Instead of just giving a plain reply, the Nabi alayhi salam read the ayah from Surah Yunus in the glorious Quran. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم ألا إن أولياء الله لا خوف عليهم ولا هم يحزنون. Where Allah states majestically clear that verily on the awliya of Allah, the friends of Allah, there is no grief and there is no worry. This the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam meant that those people who will be seated on thrones and pulpits of light and nur will be that category of people whom we know as the awliya of Allah, the friends of Allah. And throughout history, we know that there were many awliya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But today, one person who stands out, who we'll focus on in our discussion, is the great wali of Allah known as Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullahi alayhi. And at present we are in the month of Rabiul Thani, which means the month of the second spring in the lunar calendar. A month of joy, a month of happiness. Now at present throughout the Muslim world, you will see people having the urs, celebration of the life of Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi. Many people, including a group from this masjid, will be going in the next few days to Baghdad in Iraq to take part in the annual urs and the life celebration and the legacy of this great wali of Allah, Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi. But at the same time, and in the same breath, I want to say that Islam does not teach us that our lives and actions must be purely ritualistic. Not only ritual, but rather move to transformation of spiritual. And therefore, we do not look at the life of Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi to be entertained by his life or different anecdotes or stories, but rather we look at the legacy he left behind, the lessons we can learn from his beautiful, noble life. Who was the Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi? It is accepted throughout the Muslim world that he was the greatest wali of Allah that lived. He was a direct descendant of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam from the side of Imam Hassan and the side of Imam Hussein radiallahu ta'ala anhuma. He was a great alim, a great Sufi, a giant spiritual luminary. And indeed, if you look at part of his legacy, his books that he authored, one such book is known as Sirrul Asrar, which means the secret of secrets, and many other books. You find that the teaching that Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi emphasized on the most is the quality of humility. To be humble, not to be arrogant, not to be conceited, not to be puffed up with pride, thinking ourselves to be better than the next person. In fact, he emphasizes this point by saying, never ever look down upon another person thinking that you are better than the next person. And the advice he gives to the young ones, to the youth, he say, never look down upon the seniors and the elderly people, because they have been longer in this world than you, and therefore they have more ibadah to their credit. And to the elderly, he says, never look down and insult and condemn the youth, because they were a lesser time than you in this world, and therefore they have less sins. So we can see the beautiful lesson of mutual love, of mutual respect, of mutual positive outreach for one another. This was one of the great, great legacy teachings of Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi. I want to share with you one beautiful anecdote that happened to Sayyid Abdul Qadir in his lifetime. And we know that the spiritual people, they have spiritual experiences and accounts that we as ordinary people can sometimes not even think about. And this Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi, one day a bright light appeared in front of him. And the person within this light said to him, O Abdul Qadir, I am Allah. And I am very pleased with you. And from today on, whatever is haram, I declare halal for you. Listen carefully. Immediately, Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi said, A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. Get away from me, you Satan. For he immediately recognized that this can only be Shaitan. And when he said that, this bright light became an ugly darkness, and a severe stench was emanating from this darkness. And Shaitan was taken aback. And he asked Sayyid Abdul Qadir, "O Abdul Qadir, how did you recognize me?" So Sayyid Abdul Qadir said, "Even Nabi Musa alayhi salam asked Allah, 'O Allah, I want to see you.' And Allah said, 'Lan tarani,' you cannot see me, O Moses." And Musa alayhi salam said, "But Allah, I want to see you." And Allah said, "Look to the mountain. If the mountain can withstand my tajalli, my divine nur, then you will be able to see me, O Musa." And when Musa alayhi salam turned, he saw the entire mountain erupted and exploded into little pieces of dust. Allah just casted an iota of Allah's divine nur on that mountain. And Musa alayhi salam fainted, and he realized that it is a blessing that we do not see Allah in this world, because we will never be able to withstand the divine nur and the power of Almighty God Allah. So Sayyid Abdul Qadir said to Shaitan, "If Nabi Musa, who was a great prophet and Rasul of Allah, cannot see Allah, he couldn't see Allah in this world, how do you expect me to see Allah?" Therefore, I immediately knew that you were Shaitan. And secondly, he said, "Your voice when you spoke to me came from one particular direction. And my Allah is not confined to one direction. My Allah is omnipresent. My Allah is everywhere. So his voice cannot come from one direction. And therefore I knew you are Shaitan." And then Shaitan realized that he was defeated by Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani. But he still didn't give up hope. And this is a beautiful lesson we can learn from here. He still didn't give up. And he said, "O Abdul Qadir, I salute you. It is indeed your great knowledge that has saved you from me." And again, Sayyid Abdul Qadir said, "A'udhu billahi minash shaitani rajim. You cursed devil. No, it is not my knowledge that saved me from you. I am saved from you by the grace and the mercy and the qudra of Allah." And you see how Shaitan works. He works in those mysterious ways. And not only the Shaitan, the Shayateen that you find amongst mankind also. Because Allah is the one who tells us in the glorious Quran that as you get the evil jinn and the Shayateen from amongst the jinn, "Alladhi yuwaswisu fi sudurin nas min al-jinnati wan nas," you find Shayateen amongst the jinn and Shayateen amongst the people and mankind as well. People who try to take you off from the right path. People who are constant warmongers. People who don't like to see that everything goes smooth in the Muslim community. Even though some of these people are professed Muslims, they are in fact and in reality, according to the Quran, they are shayateen by nature. They are devils and demons by nature, because of their nature to mislead others and to bring about fitna and warmongering and infighting in this beautiful ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, whom the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam left behind as a great nation, a great people who gave civilization to the world when the world was sunk into the dark ages, in the middle ages, when the European people didn't know what it was to wash themselves, when people were living like barbarians. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his legacy was this ummah left behind to give guidance to a world. What has happened to this ummah? And therefore it's important for us not only to look into the seerah of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, but look at the lives of the noble sahaba, the lives and the sacrifices of Ahlul Bayt, the family of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam, the lives and the legacy of our great awliya, what they have left behind, the teachings that they have left behind. This will bring us back to greatness. And if you look at the life and the whole entire biography of Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi, you can only be moved in the right direction and impressed at this great personality who is considered to be the greatest wali of all times. But I'm asking you, let us reflect. Where did all this start? Where did his greatness start? Where did his magnificence and this great man and alim and sufi that he became, where did it all commence? It started with his beloved mother. His beloved mother, that when she was hamil and pregnant of him, she used to read the Quran constantly, non-stop. And this is what I always encourage our women, that when they are pregnant, read the Quran aloud as much as possible. Read dhikr and the remembrance of Allah aloud, because the baby inside the womb responds. And Allah has given the baby inside the blessed womb of the mother the power of hearing and the power of sight. They move with the sounds that they hear from the outside. It is even recorded in some books written by great ulama who say that his mother read the Quran so profusely that when Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi was born, he was born 29 juz, hafiz of the Quran. This is awliya, what we call karamat. It's actually karama, which mean the miraculous deeds that are performed and shown by the awliya of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the ulama states that when a prophet performs a miracle, it is known as mu'jiza. And when a wali of Allah performs a miracle, it is called karama. What we say karamat is a distorted form of the word karama, miraculous deeds from the lives of the awliya. It started with his mother who brought him up and imbibed in him a legacy by saying to him, "Oh my son, never ever compromise righteousness, never ever compromise truthfulness, and wherever you are and in whatever situation you are in, never tell a lie, always speak the truth." And if you study the life biography of Sayyid Abdul Qadir as a young boy, when he was traveling in the caravan, his mother sent him to Makkah and various places to go and learn. A group of robbers attacked that caravan, and they robbed everyone except Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani rahmatullah alayhi as a young boy. Why? Why didn't they even touch him or look at him? Because of his impoverished appearance, his tattered clothing he was wearing. He looked poor. He looked like someone who had nothing. And just perchance, one of the robbers asked him, "Do you have anything on you?" And he said, "Yes, I've got gold coins sewn into my clothing." And they were taken aback. They called the leader of the group and said, "Listen to this young man." And when they opened his clothing, they found the gold coin sewn by his mother inside his clothing. And they told him, "The way you look, we wouldn't even have searched you. How come you gave your own game away?" I mean, who of us will say to the robbers, "He said no"? Who of us will do that? I won't do it. When they ask him, "Why did you give your own game away? Why did you say this? Why did you tell us there were gold coins sewn into your clothing?" He said, Listen to the simple answer. He said, because my mother told me never to tell a lie. This is the kind of legacy imbibed in this great man by his mother. And therefore, us sitting here as parents today, do not only be entertained by this story, but can you imagine we are raising we are raising our children with proper akhlaq, raising our children with righteousness, with truthfulness, and preparing a better society and community for tomorrow. I am very, 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 very worried about our youth today. I'm very worried. Besides the fact, if I look back at the time when we went to school, the teachers gave us a hiding. Today, the students give the teachers a hiding. Supported by their parents, supported by their families, would tell teachers and educators in no terms, in every way, that you don't touch my child. Can you imagine we bring up children imbibed with Quran and Sunnah and love for the Sahaba and the Awliya? We will have a much better community, because Satanism, wallahi, Satanism is taking over this whole world. A massive church in America has opened recently, the Church of Satan. And they were parading through the streets. And many of their members were in chains like dogs. And they had joy in crawling around like dogs and acting like animals. Our children are watching this, playing satanic games on their phones, on Google, on the internet. I'm asking you with the greatest concern, beloved parents, do you have control over your children? Do you have control over what they are watching? Why do you give them movies and PlayStation games that is of no benefit to them? When are we going to reintroduce that practice we had in our Muslim homes, where we used to tell the stories of Sahaba, the stories of the Awliya, in order to inspire our children and prepare them to be the best community the following generation? Alhamdulillah, all is not doom and gloom. Great things are happening in our community. Great things. And I'm proud to mention and refer to a young lady by the name of Fatima Jakut, who is the first Muslim woman pilot flying massive planes from point A to point B to point C. And I mention this today because we need to be proud of our people's achievements. Because already we are bombarded by mainstream media about negativity after negativity. We need to mention the great achievements of our people, contemporary people, that our youth must realize that even the sky is not the limit for what you want to achieve. And you can do it if you have as a base, the love for Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam. I'm going to attempt what Hazrat Allama Iqbal rahmatullah alayhi said in Urdu, and please excuse my Urdu. He said, "Ki Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam se wafatu ne to ham tere hai, ye jaha cheez kiya loho kalam tere hai." He say, if you have as your foundation the love for Sayyidina Muhammad Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, then the pen of your destiny is in your hands. You write your destiny, destiny of greatness. Let us lay firmly the foundation of love for Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Love for his Ahlul Bayt, his beloved family, of whom the Prophet's last words were, I leave behind two things, the Quran and my Sunnah. And in another hadith he said, I leave behind two things, the Quran and my family. Whosoever hold to them, you will never go astray. Love for the Sahaba, love for our great awliya. And when I speak of awliya, it is not a strange phenomenon to this beautiful Western Cape or South African community, because we as a community are surrounded by a circle of great awliya who brought Islam here, who firmly laid down a tasawuf Islam, a spiritual Islam, entrenched our roots in tasawuf and spirituality. And unless and until we come back to that legacy, we will fall more and more down into the gutters where we are. Look around you in the Muslim world, in Palestine, in Kashmir, Afghanistan, of late, at the moment, more than 1 million Muslims, I don't know exactly how to pronounce the word, Uyghurs, Muslims are in concentration camps in China, where they are forced to eat pork, they are forced to imbibe wine, they are forced to insult Allah and the Prophet and Islam, and they are forced by scaring them with snakes, and the teeth are pulled out, nails are pulled off, and the only crime is that they are Muslim and the world is silent about it. Where are the champions of human rights? Where are the so-called champions of justice? Because it is Muslims. Muslims that are suffering. And how many of us know the situation throughout the world today? I'm happy that the Muslim Views is out today. I want to encourage you to get that Muslim Views, because they give you an update there of what is happening in China at the moment. The Chinese government is, of course, denying these reports, but they are inside information that filtered out, that came out, that make the world aware of what is happening to my and your Muslim brothers and sisters. And if any part of the Muslim world is in pain, we cannot deny that. We are one body, we all feel the pain. So may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, in this great month of Rabiul Thani, as many Muslims throughout the Muslim world is celebrating the urs and the legacy and the life of Sayyid Abdul Qadir Jilani, rahmatullah alayhi. May Allah grant us that we study the biography of these great awliya and the sahaba and the seerah of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, that we understand it, imbibe it, and we change for the better. Ameen, ya Rabbal Alameen.